Obviously, we'll be looking to get some horses from the novice into the Grade Bs, also to make sure we get two heats of both for the big meetings this season. So that's field of six, and we will get one horse through to the novice for the next weekend at Kington Vale of Arrow races.
So here is number 14, Boldness. Drag forward the gate with Boldness. Okay, you got that? Here now is number 9, Arctic Prince, driven today by Derek Pritchard. Arctic Prince, you're two out. Two out on the gate. Derek driving Arctic Prince today, because we were on this week on this horse. It's by a length on Monday, perhaps not here then. So, there's your one ride for this race, really. There's number 16, the Nadal, after travelling in the sea. Two rounds off the gate, that's the Nadal. Three rounds off the gate, the Nadal. Coming down now is the horse that is third in this race, the race behind. Just one for an Arctic Prince on Monday. See you, Chateau, you're on the inside. We've got the best horses in the race, not as common in this race. And one of them will progress to the novice.
Two out.
One more, Mr. Dow. Three out. This will call the Bobby the Mark family. Robert, you're still six, you'll tuck in, Robert, all right? Tuck in on the second row. And I think the only one we want to see now will be the proper man. Sweeping the ball, that's sticky ground on the Monday. Mark, you're drawn. Five out to the proper man. Five out to the proper man.
Number 9.
But one more horse, I think this horse will be suited by today's going conditions.
There.
There. There. Can you have a short draw inside the gate? Number? Boldness, you're 4 out. You've got that, Boldness? 4 out, thank you. Mr. Sokol, unfortunately, he got the short straw today, but. So they're going quietly round to the start now. The Fafferman will swing in with them. Round comes Mark Evans with the Fafferman. So you've got C. of Chateau on the inside of Arctic Prince. Then they're out in the goal. Following on the outside of the goal will be Goldness. On the wide outside will be the Fafferman. And then tracking them in will be Tisselpearl. So we've got a very strong baby novice division today. We haven't seen sort of almost 20 runners in the baby novice down at Amman for many years now. Our racing. So, start car picks them up. Arctic Prince just swerving a little bit at the gate. He hasn't seen much of the gate. He was only on the gate, I think, for one run. And he looks to see if Chateau's taken hold on the inside. False start has been called, our first false start of the day. Very clean today. Right now, go on now with that start game. These 20 yard horses are really keen. Arctic Prince is slowing to the round now. So I see a Chateau on the inside, the white flag is raised. I would think this time now at this speed there's no chance of a stopping them. See a Chateau on the inside of Arctic Prince, then we've got Nadal, Boldness, and on the outside the Popperman. Go! And away they go, and Arctic Prince strips out of the gate on the outside again. Popperman is checked over to Thistlepearl at the back. But Arctic Prince holds Nadal on that first turn. They've got a heel's touch. They're not going to leave these two experienced drivers. It's Nadal at that turn. It's on the outside of Arctic Prince and Derek Pritchard. Onto the back string they go for the first time. Nadal goes to take a two-length lead from Arctic Prince. In third place there, I think it's Sia Chateau, who's got a lovely toe round. Then we've got on the inside the Copper Man of Boldness, and at the back is Thistlepearl. Trowman tries to slow it up a little bit in front, I think at the top of the back straight. He's got a breather into the row. In second place is Arctic Prince. On the outside, the Papa Man. Still on the inside is CU Chateau, followed by, at the back then, I can see Tissle Pearl. And Goldness is on the outside, is it? Is it Goldness that's on the outside there? In fourth place, I think. Down to the bell we come, and CU Chateau moves out to the outside of Arctic Prince. But it's still the bell that leads. The Papa Man is leaping Evans, comes up the inside. It's Mark Evans with the Papa Man, followed by Tissle Pearl. Up to the back straight for the final time, and Nadal leads still. But CU Chateau is right there with him, and Evans, Thomas is trying to make amends for that. With a bad luck, the other Monday, we've got Tim Bell of the South team. And up front it's Nadal. Nadal from CU Chateau. In third place is Arctic Prince. The Papa Man's making ground for fourth. Then we've got Tissle Pearl to come back to Goldness. They hit the top of the back straight for the final time. It's still the goal for by a length from CU Chateau. It looks like this is a lovely front running drive from Matthew Trowmans. He's made every post the winning post what he got with. It's Nadal that leads. Halfway down the home straight, Nadal from CU Chateau. In third place, this is the Papa Man. If Nadal leads this race, this is Nadal by 2 lengths. Nadal is a perfect number. Nadal is second CU Chateau, third the Papa Man. Fourth out of this, fifth of Tissle Pearl at the back of Lowness, but a very impressive performance here by Nadal. For the Vale of Arra races at Kington next Saturday, Nadal is now a novice pony. So don't think on this, every novice will see you Chateau. Another cracking run from CU Chateau, finishing second. The Papa Man, Mark Evans. And here's Matty Jones here, picking up that drive. Dropped to the front, saved a little bit up the line, and just pulled away down the long straight. Very impressive here on the dial. So that's a double in the daily novice for the Little Abbott & Reese Stable with Margaret. Tissle Opal winning the second division, Nadal winning the third division. So that's a very good day for Linda with both her young horses. Many congratulations, Linda, and also to Matthew for a perfect drive. Well done, Matt.